Now let's talk about blood vessels. What are blood vessels? As we spoke, we'll discuss about capillary and veins. Now let's talk about capillaries. What are capillaries? We know capillaries are the structure connecting arterioles to the veins. Venules connect. They are present in vast network in our bodies. We can see now here 2N capillaries had 2N. These are arterial end and the venules end and the intervening capillaries between them. Here we can see that capillaries are lined by endothelium and fenestrations are present in between them, which are freely permeable to the water and low molecular weight solutes but impermeable to the plasma protein. Now, hydrostatic and osmotic pressures are the opposing factors that drive the capillary exchange. The most common type of edema is the vasogenic edema that results from the hypertension, hyperproteinemia and trauma. We can see in this picture that capillary microcirculation, it is a normal blood vessel due to increase in the hydrostatic pressure and decrease in the colloidal osmotic pressure leads the fluid in the interstitial space from the blood vessels to pass into the interstitial space. Let's talk about another blood vessels, that is veins and edema. What are veins? We know veins are the thin wall collectors of blood. Low pressure in the venules allows the capillary base to drain into them. They contain valves which prevent backflow of blood. Lower extremity actually shows the pitting type of edema. Chronic venous insufficiency is caused by damaged valves in which blood pools in the veins, straining the vessel walls. We can see in the picture that here the normal blood vessel is present where due to fluid leakage may cause the fluid to pass from the blood vessels into the interstitial space and leads to swelling of the leg. Let's talk about now lymph vessels and edema. Here we can see in the picture the lymph vessels, lymph node, blood vessels and muscles. What are lymph vessels actually we query of? The lymphatic system originate as lymph capillaries. We join to form the larger vessels. Here in the picture we can see the green color structure is the lymphatic system, lymphatics, which is a blinding single layer overlying endothelial cells. It is more permeable than the blood vessels having big lumen. The lymphatics are joined together by lymph node that act as a filter and finally drains into the right lymphatic duct and thoracic duct. Now, blocked lymph channels may be caused by infection, filariasis, scar tissues, and it also sometimes may be caused due to cancer treatment that results in the lymphedema. We can see in this picture that this is a cause of filariasis that occurs due to the obstruction of the lymphatic circulation. Now, let's talk about interstitium and edema. First, we will think what is interstitium? It is the space between the two cells that contains fibers that can be elastic fiber, collagen fiber, etc. and ground substance. Interstitial fluid are the fluid present between the two cells containing nutrients from capillaries and waste products from cells due to metabolism. During edema, increased extra interstitial fluid is bounded by a proteoglycan filament meshwork of tissues so that this cell fluid does not flow easily through the tissues.